Yeah, good morning all.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning all. Actually, we all learned the chemical kinetics lesson. We discussed a chemical kinetics lesson where we discussed about rate of reaction, and rate of reaction is affected by the different factors like concentration of reactants, temperature, catalyst. Now today we are going to perform one experiment regarding the chemical kinetics. First, I'll make you, I'll explain the theory, the procedure, and then we'll perform the experiment. We'll see how we can perform the experiment.
Okay, sir.
So today we are going to explain, or we are going to learn about kinetic study on the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. Now we already learned that chemical kinetics, it deals with the study of reaction rates and their mechanisms. We know that are moderate. So this chemical kinetics, it will give information regarding, or it will deals with study of reaction rates and their mechanisms. And even the factors such as temperature, concentration, pressure, and catalyst, how they'll affect the rate of a chemical reaction, we discussed in chemical kinetics. And the basic thing we learned that the rate of reaction is decrease in concentration of reactants, or increase in concentration of products divided by time taken. Decrease in concentration of reactants or increase in concentration of products by time taken is the rate of a reaction. Now today we learn how the rate of a chemical reaction is dependent on the concentration of reactants. Okay. First, I'll make you see some procedure. You try to observe that carefully, and afterwards we know what is we'll understand what is happening there. Okay, so today we are going to learn about the experiment, a kinetics study on the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. And I hope that every one of you are having notes and you are noting down the procedure and what is happening in this video.
We require 0.1 molar potassium iodide solution in 4 different conical flasks, distilled water, measuring jars, 2.5 molar sulfuric acid, starch solution, 0.05 molar sodium thiosulfate solution, 3% hydrogen peroxide solution, glass rod and stopwatch. Take 5, 10, 15 and 20 milliliters of 0.1 molar potassium iodide solution in 4 conical flasks A, B, C and D respectively. Measure 10 milliliters of 2.5 molar sulfuric acid in a measuring jar. Pour it into conical flask A. Re- repeat the same procedure for the remaining flasks. Measure 85 milliliters of distilled water in a measuring jar. Pour it into flask A to make the total volume of the solution 100 milliliters. Then measure 80 milliliters of distilled water. Pour it into the flask B to make the total volume of the solution 100 milliliters. Add 75 milliliters and 70 milliliters of distilled water to the flasks C and D respectively to make the volume 100 milliliters. Measure 5 milliliters of starch solution in a measuring jar. Pour it into flask A. Repeat the same procedure for the remaining flasks. Take 10 milliliters of 0.05 molar sodium thiosulfate solution. Add it into the flask A. Repeat the same procedure for the remaining flasks. Then take 5 milliliters of 3% hydrogen peroxide solution. Pour it into flask A and start the stopwatch immediately. Stir the mixture using a glass rod and watch for the blue color to appear. Note the time when the blue color just appears. Repeat the experiment by adding 5 milliliters of 3% hydrogen. Peroxide solution to flasks B, C and D and record the time taken in each case for the blue color to just appear. Plot a graph.
Now here we have taken four conical flasks A, B, C and D. Now these are the requirements: 0.1 molar potassium iodide solution, 2.5 molar sulfuric acid solution and distilled water, starch solution, 0.05 molar sodium thiosulfate solution, 3% hydrogen peroxide solution. We'll take four conical flasks A, B, C and D, and in A we'll add 5 ml of potassium iodide 0.1 molar, in B 10 ml of 0.1 molar potassium iodide, in C 15 ml of 0.1 molar potassium iodide solution, and in D 20 ml of 0.1 molar potassium iodide solution. Now in all the conical flasks A, B, C and D, we'll add 10 ml of 2.5 molar sulfuric acid solution. Now you can see in conical flask A, 5 ml potassium iodide and 10 ml sulfuric acid, 15 ml has been there. To make the total to 100 ml, we'll add 85 ml of distilled water to make the volume to 100 ml. Now in conical flask B, 10 ml potassium iodide is there, 10 ml sulfuric acid is there, total 20 ml. So we'll add 80 ml of distilled water. In conical flask C, 15 ml potassium iodide solution and 10 ml sulfuric acid solution, total 25 ml. So we'll add 75 ml of distilled water. And in D, 20 ml of potassium iodide So in D, 20 ml of potassium iodide and 10 ml of sulfuric acid, total will be 30 ml. So we'll add 70 ml, 70 ml of distilled water. So the total will be 100 ml. Now in all the conical flasks A, B, C and D, we'll add 5 ml of starch solution. Okay. Now here, after adding 5 ml of starch solution, we'll add 10 ml of 0.05 molar sodium thiosulfate solution in all the conical flasks A, B, C and D. Okay. Now here we are adding 5 ml of 3% hydrogen peroxide solution again in all the conical flask A to B. Now, why we are adding sulfuric acid is the reaction should take place in acidic medium. And here the starch acts as indicator. Okay. Now, the reactants are potassium iodide and hydrogen peroxide. As we told, the experiment is kinetic study on the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. Okay. Hydrogen peroxide and potassium iodide. They are reactants. We are adding sulfuric acid for the reaction to occur in acidic medium, and we are adding starch which acts like indicator. Now we can observe that immediately after adding H2O2 hydrogen peroxide solution, we should start stirring. Okay, you observed that they started stirring and they have started stopwatch. We should start the stopwatch, and we need to note the time when the blue color appears. Now the colorless solution will turn to blue color. In the first case, that will be 265 seconds. And in the second case, 138 seconds. In the conical flask C, 96 seconds. In conical flask D, 74 seconds. Now from the table only you can observe, as the concentration of Ki increases, the time for the appearance of blue color decreases. So from this table we observed that as the concentration of the ml concentration of reactants, as you're increasing the volume of concentration of reactants, what is happening here? The volume of reactants has been increased, so the time for the appearance of the blue color has been decreased. Okay, so this is the experiment to show that the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide, where the rate of reaction depends on iodide ions itself. We are maintaining the constant amount of sulfuric acid, starch solution, sodium thiosulfate and hydrogen peroxide, but we are changing only the volume of potassium iodide, which shows that the rate of reaction, it depends on the concentration of reactant potassium iodide. Now after this experiment, we need to plot a graph
A, C and D and record the time taken in each case for the blue color to just appear. Plot a graph between time taken for the appearance of blue color and 1 by volume of potassium.
So we'll plot a graph between time for the appearance of blue color in seconds, we'll take on a y-axis, and 1 by volume of potassium iodide will take on x-axis.
Iodide by taking time along ordinate and 1 by volume of potassium iodide along abscissa. It should be a straight sloping line.
So it should be a straight sloping line. The graph between time for the appearance of blue color in seconds and 1 by volume of potassium iodide will be a straight sloping line.
From this reaction, we can infer that the rate reaction of iodide ions with hydrogen peroxide increases with increase in concentration of iodide ions.
So this is the inference. We can say that rate reaction of iodide ions with hydrogen peroxide increases with increase in concentration of iodide ions. As I told, we are maintaining the constant amount of sulfuric acid, which is 10 ml, and constant amount of starch, which is 5 ml, constant amount of sodium thiosulfate, which is 10 ml, constant amount of hydrogen peroxide, which is 5 ml. But as we change the volume of reactant potassium iodide, the rate of reaction changes. The time for the appearance of blue color is changing. Now, this is the experiment, and what is happening in the reaction? Okay, I hope you have understood the procedure.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Now I hope everyone have understood the procedure, and what is happening behind that procedure we'll see. So we understood the theory, whatever the procedure and how to do the experiment. Now we are taking hydrogen peroxide and potassium iodide in acidic medium, the sulfuric acid. Now what happens when iodine reacts with sodium thiosulfate? You are getting iodide ions. When you are adding starch, iodine react with the starch and it will form a complex. At last we are getting the blue color. The appearance of blue color is due to the blue complex which is between iodine and starch. Okay, so this is the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. This reaction is taking place in acidic medium, that's why we are adding sulfuric acid. And when iodine and thiosulfate ions react, we are getting iodide ions. And when you are adding starch, iodine reacts with the starch. Okay, and to form a complex, whenever you are adding starch, okay, you should add sodium thiosulfate. Okay, why you are adding sodium thiosulfate? To liberate iodide ions. Okay, we are adding sulfuric acid because the reaction has to take place in acidic medium. You are adding starch because it is an indicator. You are adding potassium iodide and hydrogen peroxide because they are the reactants. And you are adding sodium thiosulfate to liberate iodide ions. And when you are adding starch, the iodine and starch will form a blue complex. Okay, that will give information regarding the rate of reaction. Okay, now I'll make you see how to do the experiment, and then you can do the experiment. See, this is there's an option called simulator. This is an app called Online Labs, and this is a simulator. Now here, volume of KI, what we have to add: volume of KI, volume of water, volume of sulfuric acid 10 ml, volume of starch 5 ml, volume of sodium thiosulfate 10 ml, volume of hydrogen peroxide 5 ml. You know, these are constant: volume of sulfuric acid, starch, sodium thiosulfate, hydrogen peroxide, they are constant, 10, 5, 10 and 5 respectively. As I told, we can change the volume of KI here, where the volume of water will be adjusted. Now see, if you want to do for example, now I would like to keep volume of KI 10 ml. I'll keep 10 ml. Now volume of water will be 80 ml, because 80 plus 10 plus 10. Okay, Pooja, are you able to are you listening and you are able to understand?
Yes sir.
Yeah, good. Now volume of KI, I made it as 10 ml. So the volume of KI, I made it as 10 ml, and volume of water has been adjusted automatically to 80 ml. Now you observe the volume of water when I'm changing. It is adjusting, Kathy. Yeah, okay, good. So now I'll make volume of KI 10 ml, volume of water is 80 ml. These are all okay. Now here you can see, now KI is there, 10 ml. Now I'll make you see how to do this. You have to perform the experiment. Now we'll see. See, I'm clicking here, this 0.1 molar KI, and I'm bringing here to the measuring jar, and I am pouring. Now I'm pouring 10 ml of potassium iodide, and I'm pouring the 10 ml of potassium iodide in the conical flask. Then 10 ml of 2.5 molar sulfuric acid I'm bringing here, I'm pouring in the measuring jar, and I'm pouring that in conical flask. Now I poured 10 ml sulfuric acid, 10 ml potassium iodide, which is 20 ml. Now I have to pour 80 ml distilled water. I am clicking here, I am bringing to the measuring jar, I am pouring 80 ml, and this 80 ml, you can observe in measuring jar also, that that is up to 100 ml. You can see that 80 ml it has been filled. Now this 80 ml distilled water has been poured into conical flask. Now what is next? Volume of starch is 5 ml. I am bringing the starch here, and I am pouring 5 ml starch, and this 5 ml has been poured in conical flask. Now next, 10 ml of sodium thiosulfate I am bringing here, I am bringing this sodium thiosulfate here to the measuring jar, and I am pouring in measuring jar, and that 10 ml has been poured in conical flask. And last one is hydrogen peroxide. I have to pour 5 ml. See, I'll bring here, and I'm keeping here, and it will take 5 ml. See, it is stirring and the time has started automatically. You can observe, am I right? it is stirring and time has been started automatically. Now we'll see. You observe that conical flask, slowly we'll get the blue color. The seconds it is going. Okay, the stopwatch has been started automatically and we'll wait and we'll see for the appearance of blue color. So this is a reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. We are adding sulfuric acid because this has to take place in acidic medium. To make the total volume to 100 ml, we are adding distilled water. And we are adding starch because starch is an indicator. Whenever there is a reaction with iodine, we'll use starch as indicator only. Whenever there is a reaction with iodine, we'll use starch as indicator. Okay. And sodium thiosulfate, we are adding to produce iodide ions. Okay. Now hydrogen peroxide we are adding because that is one more reactant, because the reaction is between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide. Okay. See, now the time is 1 minute 23 seconds. Okay, the stopwatch will be automatically started and it will stop it will start automatically and it will stop automatically. So the only thing we have to adjust is volume of KI only. Okay. Now, meanwhile, I want everyone to open online labs in one of the Google Chrome. I want every one of you to open this online labs. Just type online labs in Google Chrome. And there the subjects will be there. Oh, now you see, Kathy, did you observe that? It has turned to blue color. Kathy, did you observe that it has been turned to blue color?
Yes, sir. I observed, sir.
No, what is the time?
2 minutes 18 seconds.
Ah, good. Okay. Now, 2 minutes 18 seconds is the time where automatically it has stopped. Okay. Now, I want everyone to open that online labs in one of the Google Chrome tab and click the chemistry. Okay. Now, see, after this, how much KI solution I took, I'll write here 10 ml. Now you see 1 by 10 it gave automatically. Now the time is, I'll write in seconds, 2 minutes 18 seconds. What is that? 138 seconds. Okay. That is 138 seconds. Yeah, Jahnavi, you performed the experiment by sharing your screen. Yeah. Good simulator, you go down. Yeah, good. Now you adjust the volume of KI to 16 ml. Yeah, okay. Now you explain whether you, when you are good.
First, we need to take 16 ml of KI to the measuring cylinder.
Yeah, good.
Now we should add it to the control flask.
Yeah, good. Good. Mm.
Now we need to take 10 ml of H2SO4 to the measuring cylinder.
Yeah.
Again, now we should add this to the control form. Now we should take 74 ml of water. Now 5 ml of starch.
Yeah.
Now we need to add sodium thiosulfate.
How much ml?
10 ml.
Yeah, good.
Now we should add 5 ml of H2O open.
Good. Continue.
We need to add 5 ml of H2O
open. So you have added H2O2 and the stopwatch has been started automatically, and now we'll wait for the blue color to appear. Okay. Jahnavi, we are waiting for the color to change to blue color. You observe, and as we told, automatically it will stop. Okay, we'll see. Oh, you see, it has been turned.
Yes, sir, it has been turned.
Now, what is the time?
1 minute 30 seconds.
1 minute 30 seconds. That means how many seconds? Now, how much ml we took here? Jahnavi, you tell how much ml of KI we took.
16 ml, sir.
16 ml. And what is the time in seconds?
90 seconds. Sir.
90. So we performed 2, and immediately. Here the symbol is their graph. Okay, you click this. Now you see we got the graph, which is a straight sloping line. Am I right? See, we performed 2 experiment, and after doing that experiment in the same way, okay, you can write here. For example, I'll take a 20 ml. You can change the potassium iodide ml. And automatically time, and you can click here the chart. So in this way, see, I performed experiment here in the same way. You have also performed experiment here. And Jahnavi, as you perform the experiment, now I'd like to ask you some viva questions. You should tell. Okay, in the same way for others also, we'll do this in the next class. Now Jahnavi, you tell, in which medium does the reaction between iodide ions and hydrogen peroxide takes place?
It's with medium.
Acidic. Okay, I'm keeping for you. Now, which ion is formed when potassium iodide reacts with sodium thiosulfate in an acidic medium in the presence of hydrogen peroxide?
H minus.
A, B, C, D. You tell me.
B, sir.
Huh? You tell me A, B, C, D.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Next, third question. Which one of the following is used as an indicator in the reaction between this reaction? Which is the indicator here?
Stark solution, sir. Option C.
Okay, now what is observed when potassium iodide reacts with sodium thiosulfate in an acidic medium in the presence of hydrogen peroxide using a starch indicator? What is observation?
Appearance of blue color, sir. Option
B. Now, which one of the following complexes is responsible for the blue color obtained in the reaction between potassium iodide and sodium thiosulfate in the presence of hydrogen peroxide using a starch indicator?
Starch and thiosulfate complex.
Which one? A, B, C, D. Quick.
C, sir.
C. Now, how can we estimate the rate of reaction between potassium iodide and sodium thiosulfate in the presence of hydrogen peroxide using a starch solution as indicator? A, B, C, D.
C, sir. C.
Now, in which reaction does the following composition give a blue coloration? A, B, C, D.
B, sir.
B. Now, which one of the following acid is used to make the medium acidic in the reaction between potassium iodide and sodium thiosulfate in the presence of hydrogen peroxide?
Option
D, sulfuric acid. Okay. What is the nature of the graph obtained by plotting time for the appearance of blue color versus 1 by volume of KI?
Option 2, sulfuric acid.
consider the reaction reactant R2P. Which of the following expresses the rate of reaction?
Option 2, sir.
Option?
2.
Okay, the YY is completed. 10 questions. Now I am submitting. We'll see how many. See the first one, in which medium? Acidic medium. Now, which ion is formed? The thing is, answer is, in acidic medium, in the presence of hydrogen peroxide, we'll get iodide ion. See, the reaction is between hydrogen peroxide and iodide ions. So, which ions you'll get? Iodide ions. Now, what is the indicator you are using? You told good starch. And what is observed is appearance of blue color. Which one of the following complex? That blue color is due to starch and iodine complex, not starch and thiosulfate complex. Starch and iodine complex. And how can we estimate the rate of reaction is by measuring the time taken for formation of iodide ions, not by measuring the time taken for the appearance of blue color. Okay, sorry, the answer is by measuring the time taken for the appearance of blue color. Whatever your answer, that is wrong. And seventh is right, eighth one is sulfuric acid, ninth one is straight sloping line. And now here it is option 2. Okay, how many? 1, 2, and 3, 4. Okay, out of 10 you got 6 for this viva. And